good, Josh. Your boy Ross back at again with another video. So, last night, Money in the Bank was pretty crazy, especially towards the end of the pay-per-view. If you guys got a chance to check out my live reaction on stream last night, hey, man, you know, your boy lost his voice towards the end as John Cena came out. But, you know, I'm starting to regain my voice again, and it was enjoyable. Everyone that was in the chat the entire time, thank you so much. And everyone that showed in whenever they did show in, thank you so much for checking out the live stream. It was dope. I enjoyed it. But there are a few of you guys that don't agree with my opinion. And I originally wasn't going to make this video, but I had to because this person was very adamant on letting me know why my opinion on the Rhea Ripley versus Charlotte Flair match was incorrect. So we're going to take some time out today. I normally don't do this, but we're going to take some time out today to address this person and their comments towards my opinions about a match. So we're going to give a special warm welcome to Bella Rodriguez. She was not happy with my opinion on this particular match. So we're going to talk about this. I have it pulled up on my screen. And we're going to go by, you know, comment per comment. I responded to her this morning because I had time to today. So this match isn't really captivating me. Sir, you didn't even pay attention to Charlotte and Rhea to even be captivated. You were literally on your phone and reading chat. How could you say the match was decent? It was actually considered match of the night by many. Please actually go back and watch. Whoever considered this match of the night, I don't know what you was watching. Match of the night easily goes to the Roman Reigns and Edge match. Easily. Match of the night. Usually when Roman Reigns has a match on a pay-per-view, it's match of the night. Rhea versus Charlotte does not come close to that. Notice how she said, I said the match was decent. So in what world do we live in where decent is bad? I didn't say the match was trash. I just said it was decent. I gave the match a 5 out of 10 at best. So I responded, I did. It was okay to me, but that's about it. I'm sure others enjoyed more than me, but that's their opinion. The match was mid to me. It was okay. 5 out of 10. Decent. It's not something I'm going to remember when it comes to this pay-per-view. It's not something I'm going to go back to watch. It was okay. I didn't really care for it. She responds with a rolling my eyes emoji. So I respond back. So because I didn't agree with your opinion, then I'm wrong. I was watching the match. I just didn't really care for it. It had its highlights, and it was decent at best. That's what's wrong with wrestling fans now. You can't have an opinion, and if you do, you're wrong. I stand by that. Just because I didn't give this match a great rating, I gotta go back and watch it again. When this match came on, do you know how many people in my chat was like, yo, this is the restroom break? No one cared. They didn't. They just wasn't that invested. And let's not even take in consideration that when the match started, people were chanting for Becky Lynch. It's not a good sign. People didn't give a fuck. Why do you think Charlotte went off script and gave them the middle finger? Charlotte wasn't told to do that. She decided to do that because she was a little probably frustrated with the fans saying, yo, we don't give a fuck. We want to see Becky, bro. Please, Becky, come out here and save this match. It's a telltale sign. Now, not to say the match didn't get better. It did get better. But ultimately, it didn't really enhance their feud because Charlotte ends up winning. And we're going to talk about that at the end of this. So, where are we now? Oh, I lost my train of thought. So, she responds back, sir. I like how she uses sir. It's really, really crazy. I literally, in all caps, just watched your reaction. You literally got on Instagram, read comments, the entire time, then reacted to some spots when you heard a crowd pop. I get that people have different opinions, but honestly, your opinion is ass when you weren't even paying attention the entire time until the end. Ma'am, since we're using formal greetings, ma'am, the match was boring to me. I didn't care for it. It had some decent spots, had some decent moments. I'd rather engage in with my chat, who are there to get my reaction as well, than watch this match back again, because I didn't care for it. I didn't care that the match was literally just a rematch. Again, no stipulation, nothing. It was just them having the same match again at a different pay-per-view. It was okay. At best, I think they're not really doing a real good job at Rhea Ripley, as I guess portraying her as the face here. And Charlotte. How many times does she have to win a championship? Like, it's the same stuff. Now you're entitled to your opinion. You may have loved this match, but for me, I tried to watch it. I just didn't care. That's just what it is. So I responded again. Once again, I didn't really care about this match happening again in the same fashion. Anyway, just to put the title back on Charlotte. Please don't sit here and act like people will go back to this pay-per-view because of this match. LOL. Like I said, it was okay at best, and I stand by that. So if you feel my opinion is ass, you don't have to watch me either. It doesn't make a difference to me. So, Miss Bella Rodriguez, I want you to understand, this is strictly for you. You are the reason this video was created, so thank you, Bella. You're entitled to your opinion. You're entitled to feel how you want to feel. Miss Bella, I don't give a fuck. The match stands for me as mid at best, 5 out of 10. If you disagree with me, that is okay. That means you had another match that you enjoyed on the pay-per-view. So your overall experience should not be dampened because I didn't agree with you. The wrestling community is very, very strong on, if your opinion does not match with mine, you don't know what you're talking about. Newsflash, I'm different from you, Miss Bella Rodriguez. So what entertains me will be completely different from what entertains you. And I'm sorry, but to see the same match that I pretty much saw prior to at the last pay-per-view, and I feel like their last match at the last pay-per-view was actually more enjoyable. It was. I liked their match at Hell in a Cell better than this one. I just didn't like the ending. And of course, I didn't like the ending of this one. The reason why I don't like the ending of this one, because if you guys remember, Rhea got disqualified because she banged Charlotte's head on the wood surface of the table, and that's a disqualification. But Charlotte could literally put her leg between the steel post and the steel stairs and repeatedly kick it and don't get disqualified. I thought the ending of that last match was dumb. If we're going to stay consistent, that doesn't make sense. But she can do it. Now, I get it. Maybe they're setting up a potential cash-in, which I hope they do. I'm okay with Nikki Ash, ASH, getting her spotlight. Do I think she's going to be a long-term champion? No. I think she's going to probably be a transitional champion. But, hey, if it leads to Charlotte losing the title, cool. I'm fine. I'm okay with that. I just feel like this feud literally went nowhere. And they need to do a better job of building more women in the women's division. Because right now, I don't know how many, like, we've seen this match too many times now. So I don't know what they're going to do. The women's division, especially on the Raw side, is definitely depleted. It's not, you don't have too many stars. So maybe this was their plan to potentially help out Nikki. Get her little shine. Get her little spotlight. That's cool. But outside of that, didn't care for the ending of this match. Didn't care for the ending of their last match. Their last match I enjoyed much more than this one. And this, for me, is a 5 out of 10. You may disagree, and I'm okay with that, Miss Bella Rodriguez. But guess what? This is my opinion, and I stand on it. So if you don't like my opinion, you don't have to watch. You can watch someone else that's going to praise this match as a 9 out of 10. Don't know how, but whatevs. Either way, I would be very surprised if I find someone that says, oh man, that Rhea and Charlotte match, that was the best match of the night. I would be surprised if you said that, because I'll be like, wow, I guess the men's Money in the Bank. Granted, even though it has a gimmick to it, so that by default, it makes it a little bit more entertaining. Cool, you can take that out. I guess that the Universal Championship match, I guess that wasn't as good. Because clearly, the fans definitely was marking out more in that match than the Rhea and Charlotte match. They had their moments. That moment, their match was enjoyable for what it was. But let's be honest here. When you think of Money in the Bank 2021, you're going to think of Roman versus Edge and then John Cena coming out. You may say, oh, the Rhea match was cool. But I would be very surprised if you sat up there and said, oh, it was match of the night. That's where you lose me. So, hey, Miss Bella Rodriguez, thank you for your opinion. You gave me a great idea for a video. I had to make this video because you was very adamant to let me know my opinion is ass. And my response to you, I don't give a fuck. But I appreciate all the love and support, man. Let me know. Comment down below. If you guys thought this match was great, if you enjoyed this match, let me know why you enjoyed this match. Do you feel like this match is, you know, give me a scale on 1 to 10, just this match alone, Charlotte versus Rhea. What do you rate this match on a scale of 1 to 10 and why? I really want to know. Give me your opinions on that. I'm not here to judge anyone. If you felt like this was the best match of the night for you, I'm gonna be kind of surprised, but that's your opinion. Let me know why. Appreciate all the love and support. Road to 50K. Appreciate y'all kicking in with me, and I'll see y'all on the next one. Peace.